With Simulive webinars, you can reduce the amount of effort required to successfully run a webinar by using pre-recorded content. Simulive webinars are helpful when you want to reuse content for a webinar, such as broadcasting marketing sessions, repeating your organization's all-hands sessions across multiple time zones, delivering training, and more. In this video, you will learn how to set up a Simulive webinar, how to modify webinar options for Q&A, and how to host a Simulive webinar. Before we begin, here are some things to know about Simulive webinars. You must have a Zoom Events or Zoom Sessions license. You must have a saved recording on the Zoom cloud. Hosts and panelists cannot appear on video or speak to attendees and can only use the chat and Q&A features to communicate with the attendees. Only the speaker view is selected in the recording, even if you recorded multiple views. Hosts can't add multiple recordings to a single Simulive webinar. Attendees cannot join from a mobile browser. Let's begin by signing in to the Zoom web portal, then clicking on Webinars from the left side navigation menu. On the right, click Schedule a Webinar. Now select Simulive as the webinar type. Then click Add Recording to choose a previously recorded personal cloud recording. Click Save. After you add the recording, the webinar duration will automatically populate to a duration that encompasses the recording, but you can manually adjust as needed. You can click Watch Recording to preview the selected recording and click Change if you wish to choose a different recording. Select the webinar settings as needed, including date and time. You can create a recurring series by selecting the Recurring Webinar checkbox. Set the recurrent schedule, frequency, and end date. Note, you cannot select no fixed time. It must be daily, weekly, or monthly. Click Schedule. Your Simulive webinar will start automatically at the specified time. Now let's talk about modifying a couple of your Simulive webinar options. First, you can set up a webinar Q&A autoresponse. This is helpful when the host or panelist may not be present. When enabled, attendees will get an autoresponse when they submit a question during the webinar. For example, you can set the response to be, "Thank you for your question. We will get back to you shortly." To set up the autoresponse, scroll to the bottom of your webinar details page and click the Q&A tab. In the autoresponse section, click Edit, then choose if you want to set up an autoresponse. Note, you can turn it off if you join the webinar and decide to answer manually. Now enter your autoresponse and click Save. You can also set up a follow-up email to attendees with the link to the recording. All you have to do is copy the recording link and paste it into the email template. To get the link, go to Recordings and locate the recording you used for the Simulive webinar. Click Share, and next to Shareable link, click Copy. Next, click on Webinars from the left side navigation menu and click the topic of the Simulive webinar. Scroll to the bottom of the page and click the Email Settings tab. In the Follow-up Email to Attendees section, click Edit. And in the text box at the bottom, paste the recording link and click Save. To host your Simulive webinar, you don't have to do anything else. Simulive webinars start automatically at the scheduled time, so you aren't required to be there at the start. To control webinar host functions, join the Simulive webinar as the host. The Simulive session will launch in a desktop browser window. During the session, you can conduct Q&A and polls, chat with attendees or other panelists, and promote attendees to panelists to help answer attendee questions. You can find more information on this and other topics by visiting our support center at support.zoom.us. Thanks for watching.